Okay, sorry, some people, I don't know if anybody doesn't wear, yeah, just mute yourself, Aria. Okay, thank you. Yeah, everybody's muted now. Okay, let's go. Hallelujah. Okay. So, amen. Today we want to talk about deliverance from the spirit of poverty. Amen. That open doors to for riches. Hallelujah. So, we want to see how a man can be rich, because last time what we look at some aspects, how you can build, I can call it how you can build your capital, hallelujah. But when you build your capital, you need to invest into something, hallelujah. But if you don't know what to invest in, when to invest, and how to invest, with whom you can invest, hallelujah, you build the capital, but you throw it away, hallelujah. Amen. So I want to say that deliverance from the spirit of poverty comes with humility, fear of God, wisdom, and focus. When I'm saying focus, I want to talk about discipline. Hallelujah. Discipline. Because discipline comes from humility and focus on something. You want to achieve something, you want to get somewhere. Hallelujah. Is what we call priesthood as well. Hallelujah. Because a priest is somebody who does something regularly, but he's not doing it because he's doing it. Maybe you don't see why he's doing it, you don't see what is happening, but no, what he's doing is doing it for a purpose. Hallelujah. Obeying something, because in the eyes of his heart he have seen something, and that's why he focused on what he is doing. Hallelujah. So the spirit of poverty gives people a mentality that is very, very hard to be delivered from. That's why some people say that spirit of poverty, poverty is a mentality. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you that if you don't humble yourself, even if you humble yourself, hallelujah, it needs God to deliver somebody from the spirit of poverty. That's why I want to pray now for anybody who listens to this message, for God to deliver the person from the spirit of poverty. Hallelujah. You can gather money, but you are still poor. Hallelujah. Amen. But those who are rich, they have the money, and they have peace, and they have wisdom. Amen. So I need to pray for everyone right now. Amen. Father, I just want to thank you. Great and wonderful God. I'm destroying God, the spirit of poverty in the soul of every single person listening to this message, or who will ever listen to this message. I destroy completely the spirit of poverty. That mentality, I destroy it. The power, the spirit, whatever is in human being, human brain, and keeps the human into poverty, Father, I destroy them completely in the name of Jesus. Paralyze them in the name of Jesus. Paralyze them in the name of Jesus. Father, your grace, that gives riches. Father God, let it fall on people. Let it fall on people. Father God, anybody that needs it, run as you are here, talk to them, open their mind, open their heart to see, God, what they have never seen before, to see what they have never seen before, that will deliver them completely from the spirit of poverty. Thank you, Jesus. May your name be glorified. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, why am I saying this? I'm saying this because I want to start something. Let's just not put you off. Jesus said something. He said in Mark 14, verse 6 to 7, he said, but Jesus replied, leave her alone. Why criticizing her for doing such a good thing to me? You will always have poor among you, And you can help them whenever you want, but you will not always have me. So Jesus is telling us here that we will always have poor among us. Hallelujah. We will always have poor among us. So it is important that we understand this. Hallelujah. It's important that we understand this. But if we will always have poor among us, he's not saying that we will never have rich. Hallelujah. So it takes the grace of God to take you among out of the poor and make you rich. Hallelujah. That's why I want to name some people in the Bible who I can call rich in the eyes of God. Hallelujah. Rich in the eyes of God. I want to call Abraham, David, amen, Jacob, and Job. Amen. Except Job, I can say for sure that Abraham, Jacob, and David, God took them out of nothing and made them rich. Hallelujah. So if that God did that, he can do it for you as well. Amen. He can do it for you as well. But I want to tell you as well that the day and the time we are in is different than the day and time they were living in. Hallelujah. But this God is always God, is still God, and he can do everything anytime. Proverbs 10, verse 22 says, the blessing of God makes a person rich. Hallelujah. The blessing of God makes a person rich, and he adds no sorrow with it. That means you will be rich, but you have peace and you have joy. Hallelujah. But it's the blessing that is going to make you rich. There is some wisdom you need. There is some insight you need. Inspiration you need. There are some skills you need. All these are called the blessings of God. Hallelujah. There is something God will put in you, or certain thing God will put in you. And the way, even the when he open the eyes of your heart, make you disciplined, this will make you help you to make this will make you rich. Hallelujah. Let me tell you this. All the rich people, they are focused. Amen. They don't have time. They have activities. They are organized and they have activities. They will do this after this. They will do this after this. They will do this. And they know how to manage many, many things at the same time. Hallelujah. But when somebody is poor, what happens? He have that spirit of poverty. The eyes of his heart is closed, to the point that he cannot take pressure. He runs away from pressure. Anyway, run away from pressure. So I can say, in the vision, Jesus says something that I believe is very, very relevant to say here. He said, as the days grow darker upon the earth, I will show more of my glory. You will need this for what is coming. Even so, remember that those who serve me, even when they do not see my glory, are the faithful, obedient one to whom I will entrust my power. Obedience in the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom, but the fullness of wisdom is to obey because you love God. They will see, amen. Then you will see the power and the glory. Hallelujah. Why did I bring this out? I'm saying something that's not right. Why did the Holy Spirit remind me this to go and bring it and put it here? It's because our time to become rich is different from the time our parents or some of the people we know on earth right now have been rich, and the time the people of the Bible have been rich. But from yet God is the same today and tomorrow and forever. That means God has all power. God is always in control. Whatever you put the things, God is able to make it, to make his way, and to make whosoever you choose to make rich, you will make him rich. And that's why I'm praying that you might be, or you must be, one of them that he wants to make rich now and the near future. Hallelujah. So let's look at what the Bible is telling us in 115, Psalm 115. What I read right now is in the vision, the call, page 61, paragraph 3. Hallelujah, Jesus talking there, amen. But now let's talk about, see what page 115, verse 12 to 16. I will start with verse 16, hallelujah, verse 16. Verse 16 says, the heavens are the Lord's heavens. Hallelujah. The heavens are the Lord's heavens. Amen. Or some versions say the heavens are the Lord's. Amen. It's like the God controls all the heavens. Hallelujah. Amen. But the earth has been given to the children of men. The earth has been given to the children of men. But now we want you as well to be co-heir on earth. Hallelujah. So now I'll go to verse 12. He said, the Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. I'm reading from Amplified. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron, the priesthood. He talk about the house of Israel, talk about the house of Aaron, the priesthood. But when he's talking about the priesthood, Aaron was the high priest. Amen. In some versions, he talk about the children of Israel, talk about the priest, and talk about the high priest. Hallelujah. So let's continue, verse 13. I will bless those who reverently and worshipfully fear the Lord, both small and great. Hallelujah. So he will give them something that will help them to be in control, because the blessing of God may put you in control. When you receive the blessing, that's actually the blessing of God. If God bless you financially, you'll be in control. If God bless you spiritually, you'll be in control. Any area God bless you in, and God bless you with healing gifts, so that means when you see sickness, cannot be in control. Everywhere sickness are, or whatever, health, it come to health, you'll be in control. Because everybody surrender to you, help us you to pray for them. Hallelujah. So the blessing actually put us in control. Amen. So I'm reading again verse 13. And he will bless those who reverently and worshipfully fear the Lord, both small and great. May the Lord give you, may the Lord give you increase more and more, and you and your children. Amen. Increase more and more in you and your children. May you be blessed of the Lord. Maybe you be blessed of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Amen. Then he said the heavens are for the Lord. Amen. But he has given to the children of they have given the earth to the children of men. Amen. So it is not everyone who has. It's not everyone who has plenty that is rich. Amen. It's not everyone who has plenty that is rich. The rich that comes from God comes with peace and joy, with no sorrow. That is why the rich, amen, to be rich, amen, you need God. And God too wants his people to be rich. He wants us to be blessed, for us to be rich. Hallelujah. But the way God does things, it comes in teaching, little by little. If we are following the teaching and we are listening, that will lead us into riches. Hallelujah. Or will lead us to the level where we can find ourselves or be qualified as a rich one day. Hallelujah. But now, the poor people, if you notice, they have one mentality. They want to be happy. And the happiness comes like somebody come take you to restaurants or do something to supply one of your needs. Hallelujah. But now the rich, they have a system in place, and the system generates money and generates whatever needed to be generated for them to be able to supply all the financial or material need that they need to have. Hallelujah. But now what I want to tell you, that the riches of God, how God make us rich, is not just financial, material and financial need that we need to supply, but it supplies needs that are not even financial or material. Amen. Like peace. Money cannot buy peace. Amen. But you can buy the most expensive bed, but a comfortable bed, but it will not guarantee that you sleep on it. Hallelujah. But God can guarantee that you sleep and you have peace. Amen. So what we are talking about this morning, please, if you don't have humility, it will be difficult for you. But now, you can sometimes we have understanding. That's why I named five things. I named what? Amen. We name five things. We name humility, the fear of God, understanding, visions, hallelujah, and focus. You can have understanding, but you always understand. But and you don't know why you can never, you are never able to apply what you understand. Most of the time is humility. Some of the time is lack of focus because you have the spirit of distraction or something distract you. Because if you are edifying yourself, you'll be putting more of God in you, and that God will be helping you open your eyes to give you vision. Because there is something I learned from eagles. When you look at eagles, they don't fly in group. They don't fly in group. They fly on their own, but they can see far, and they can focus, and they successfully get what they want to get. Hallelujah. May God make you an eagle. So when we are talking about the prophetic, we are not saying, oh, everybody to be prophet. We just want people to be like Joseph and people like Daniel in whatever they are doing. You are team up with God and you are working with God. Because we are getting into an era where having the Holy Spirit, the way we have the Holy Spirit today is not enough. Will not be enough. Will not be enough. You need to have him like the way Elijah had him, the way Joseph had him, the way Moses had him, and you can talk. And hallelujah. So there are more things, but I don't want to teach prophetic. Let's go. Amen. Where I am. Hallelujah. So I can tell you that until we are delivered from the spirit of poverty, we can never become rich. Even when somebody put $1 billion on our account, we can never become rich. Hallelujah. Even $1 billion. And there are a system we are in today. And some people socially are better off than the other. But all of them are in the same category. They are not rich. But if you can have a focus and you can see yourself part of the rich, then you know how you manage your spare time in order to build what you have to build until you reach the level you are, you become rich. Some people are rich today. They started with what? Selling hot dogs. Amen? Selling hot dogs. Hallelujah. So, I'm not teaching about business. I don't want to talk about business. But I just want to talk about how we need God for God. Because to be rich today, there are many routes to be rich, to become rich, many routes. But only God can put everyone on the relevant route. Why I'm saying the relevant route? Because there are different gifts God has given all of us. So according to your gift, God can put you somewhere and give you more vision, more insight, more focus, hallelujah, and everything you need, and more people, right people that can surround you, amen, and help you, amen, for you to become rich. Hallelujah. I want to tell you, I say right now, yeah, when they put the millions in your accounts, if you have the spirit of poverty, amen, the mentality of a poor, you can never become rich. Amen. The prodigal son wasted all the money he took from his father because of the spirit of poverty. Hallelujah. The poor are not patient. When they have money or they have anything, they just want to enjoy, 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 and finish it. And that's it. They don't think about more. Amen. And they are always expecting their problem to be solved by somebody else. They are always expecting they are always thinking that their joy and happiness will depend on somebody else. Hallelujah. The poor want to gather for themselves and enjoy. Whenever they give out to someone, maybe that they are expecting somebody something from that person. Hallelujah. They are expecting something for that person. They won't give because they want to give. They won't give because they love the people or they have compassion for people. Hallelujah. The rich sees far and build a system that can continue to generate money for him and generation after him. Hallelujah. When Jesus came, Jesus didn't want to be financially rich. He didn't look after that. But he put a system in place for people to be bringing people, because Jesus came to save humanity, to bring people, to bring human heart, amen, to God. So he put a system in place for that system to be bringing human heart to God while he's gone. That's the mentality of the rich. Hallelujah. So anything that is the legacy of God wants to do with your life, you need to put a system in place for that system to continue working while you are gone. That is the mentality of the true rich. Somebody is truly and purely rich, made rich by God. Hallelujah. The rich, I said, they see far and they put system in place. Because of the grace of God upon their life, they know what to invest in, who, when to invest, and who to invest with. Amen? Or who they can work with. Amen? They don't do things because of feeling. They do things because of insights and purposes. With the spirit of discernment, we can see that the period we are going into or we are in and we have ahead are going to be worse, bad. And to be saved in those periods, it takes a great grace of God. But now we are saying not to be saved, not just to be saved. We want you to be saved and to be rich. One of the people will be in control in those tough periods. If it's not God, who can do it? If it's not with God, who can do it? Amen. That's why verse 16 says, the heavens is for the Lord, but that he has given the earth to the children of God. But now, can you be rich or one of the top people on this earth if you are not really in partnership with God? Even the Antichrist, who at some point will try to control this earth, will not be in control and will not win, will not succeed. But you, who will have the grace, who will tap into the grace we are preaching and we are releasing today, you can be in control. Amen? I want to tell you something. You remember Israel? They started in what? Theocracy, with theocracy. In theocracy, the people are governed by a priesthood, where we have the high priest From the high, we have the other priests, we have judges and all the other. But now from bureaucracy, they move into monarchy. From monarchy, now they are in democracy. And almost everyone is in democracy, even if the democracy is not pure democracy everywhere. Hallelujah. But in all the three systems, the leaders of this system are always better off compared to the rest of the people. Hallelujah. Compared to the rest of the people. Today, you can see that before in Israel, the prophets, amen, are in high position with the king. Today, you have the multinationals. You have the multinationals that are working with what? The government. They are in control. And them and their children are better off, and they are the ones who are rich. They have all the privileges. But the riches they have is just financial and material riches. They don't, not all of them have, I won't say, not all of them have the pure riches that comes from God, where you have peace that goes with it. Amen? We are moving into a new system where only those who are in and who have intimacy with God will be the overcomers, will be in control. Maybe that's why I'm saying that I need to pray for everyone. Maybe I'm saying this, but some people are not seeing it, and some people don't see far. The time will come when it will be too late. This way they will realize, this is what you were saying. But if you are truly rich, you can see tomorrow and you know what to be doing today. How you can organize yourself today, how you can plan your life today. And when tomorrow comes, you are already ready. Amen. So the Lord, verse 12 says, the Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron, the priesthood. Amen. The priesthood, those who are disciplined and do something on behalf of God and on behalf of human beings. Amen. So the priesthood we are talking about right now. So if you want to be rich today, what happens? Most of the riches, they become rich out. They see the needs in humanity. They see what human will need. As they see what human needs, so they go and seek God or research until they find solution of the need of human being. So now women always need that thing, so they need to pay for it. As they are paying for it, that's generating money for him. Hallelujah. But God wants women's need to be supplied. So you become a mediator or somebody between God and human to work with God, hallelujah, or to work with wisdom, to find whatever women need in order to be supply for a long period. I won't say forever, for a long period. That's what makes you rich. Don't think you will be rich by saving money. It's not possible. You only can be rich by solving human problems. If you cannot make your mind to solve human problems, you can never be rich. Amen. I know some politicians, they will say, they will flatten people, say, well, good. They will promise to solve problems, human problems, and that may put them in position, but they don't last there because they are liars. Because when I say they are liars, whatever is in your heart, when you are saying what is in your heart, you are not a liar. And when you come as well, you can do whatever is in your heart. But if what you are saying is something just to flatten people and to trick them, to deceive them, in order, so you, they may give you the opportunity, but it will not last. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, the key I want to tell you today is that we want to be rich, but you cannot be rich without solving human problems, without offering yourself as a living sacrifice to solve human problems. Hallelujah. You see, let me tell you this. I can say this. I have been praying for, I don't know how many years, more than 10 years I've been praying that prayer. You know, some people like people who have Down syndrome, people who have some, I don't have that medicine, so I can't call those conditions. There are some disabilities. When you have it or you are born with it, that's it. There's no more hope for you. Nobody can do anything. I look at those and I say, it's wrong. There is a God. And I have been praying. Father, I need an anointing because those people as well need a smile, need a hope. That hope can come from who if it's not you? Aliyah? It's like in the time of Jesus, there are some sicknesses. When you had it, they will isolate you. When you are isolated, immediately you know that your days are over. Unless God has mercy, you can never be healed. You are condemned. It's like some people are condemned today, but we look at it, it doesn't tell us anything. But I cry always for them. But I believe God is answering my prayers. Very soon, they are going to have more than hope. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, look around. There are a lot of things that are not right, that are not good, that are not the plans of God on humanity. Pick up one and pick up few and offer yourself as a living sacrifice before God to be the person through whom or the person who offer himself for that to be taken out of the life of some people or that to be taken out of out of humanity or out of the earth. There's no way you cannot be rich. And even when God brings money, your mind and your heart will not be on money because you didn't start with that. Unless you give up in your with your relationship with God, and then the enemy come and trick you, and you start misbehaving. Brothers and sisters, I'm saying it again, there's a lot of problem around us. In this London where we are living, in our hometown, amen, in many, many places, start with prayer. Aliyah, if you want to follow me, my roots, start with prayer. But some people's roots, Aliyah, may not be, it's going to be prayer because you want to team up with God, for God to help you. Maybe you are an engineer in some area. But in that area, there is something that is not done and that is needed. So you are praying God will give you the inspiration to manufacture something or to create something. And whatever you create will be answering the problem of people. Hallelujah. So to be rich, you need to think about human. To be rich, you need to team up with God. You need to share the vision of God or the plan of God or the burdens of God that he has upon humanity. If you don't share, you can never be rich. You can never be rich. Because some people want to be rich without purpose. No, it is a mission and purpose. Always mission and purpose. Christian to be rich is with mission and purpose. Somebody want to be rich because he want to finance the kingdom of God, the advancement of the kingdom of God. But always those who truly want to finance the kingdom of God and want to be rich, they are never joke with their tithe. Aria, let me tell you something. We know today that we have a lot of organization on the earth, a lot of foundations, big foundation with big names, riches. Amen. But why do you think these people are going to corrupt government in order to change law or to vote law that can suit the agenda they have upon the earth? They want to take the earth as Jesus wants to take the earth. So Jesus as well is looking for people whose hearts can be fully dedicated to him, to the advancement of his kingdom and his program on earth, to make them rich so they can use the money, their heart, their brain, their intelligence, everything to advance his kingdom. but very poor, very, I won't say very few Christians think about that, knows that, are focused on that. Only those who are focused on that, all those who are focused on that, and all those who are focused, I would say, you must focus on that for God to make you rich. If you focus on that, God will make you rich. Hallelujah. I'm not talking about having some few, I won't say even a million. Maybe you have 100,000 or whatever, 50,000 or whatever thousand on your account. That's not what I'm calling rich. Amen. When you are rich, the whole world knows that you are rich. This is what I'm talking about. Amen. The country you are in, the town you are in, everybody knows that you are rich. Now you have some house somewhere, people in your area, even people, you are just normal people. No, it's not what we are talking about. Hallelujah. But please don't think that you are too low or too whatever to become one of those people on earth. Don't limit yourself. That's why I say, I pray for the spirit of poverty to depart from people's mind. Hallelujah. Open your mind. Submit to God. Hallelujah. I'll give you another testimony. Recently, I was telling God that, you know, I don't know how to worship you. Teach me how to worship you. I don't want to be worshiping based on what I know. Open my eyes on your greatness. Then whatever I see is whatever I'll be describing. Then I'll be worshiping you sincerely. Not say the Bible say, the Bible say, the Bible say, or just repeating what the Bible say. I'm telling you, God, start open my eyes. As he started to open my eyes, even when I open the Bible, I read the Bible, I see another dimension of what is written there. Then I understand that those who rocks whatever is there, when God opened their eyes, what they saw is far greater than what we can just read. Hallelujah. So let's pray this morning for God to open our eyes. When I say the eyes of our hearts. So we can see the dimensions of God. We can see how great it is, what he wants to do. So we can give ourselves as a living sacrifice. People he can work with in order to take the whole earth for him. Hallelujah. So brothers and sisters, we say what? We want to be delivered from the spirit of poverty for the doors of riches to be opened. So I'm praying again. Father, deliver your people from the spirit of poverty. From today, God, take their hand and pull them. I said, pull them into all the steps they need in order to be delivered completely. And start building their life in partnership with you in order to become rich, in order to become tomorrow people on who you can count, people on who in whom you can entrust your power and your riches, everything in order to advance your kingdom on earth and to take completely this earth. Father, I just want to thank you because you are great God, wonderful God, and powerful God. May your name be glorified. Amen.